let's take a look at some features of Constant Contact's email system. So I am in Constant Contact where I have lots of emails already, and I'm going to click Create an Email. And when I do that, and I could use one of my existing ones and copy that if I wanted to, but just to show some of the features, when I go into Create, I have different templates of emails that I could choose from. So let's just say that I am Business Basic, and I'm going to go ahead and select that if I'm a business person, or if I were a teacher and I was having a student use a business letter, I might use this. Now, Constant Contact will add some pre-populated fields, so it's got my information, picture, and all. Let's say I don't want that. I can get rid of that. And you know, I don't see any need for this block here, so I'll get rid of that as well. Okay, and it already has given me the Dear Contact first name. Now this is really great, because what this is going to do is, no matter how many contacts I have, let's say I have 1,000 different emails and their names, what Constant Contact's going to do is, when I send it, it's going to put every one of their first names in. So I am markbarnes19@gmail.com, and Constant Contact, if it were sending to me, would say Dear Mark. And that's great, because it personalizes the email, and that's really important. You can see over here your colors and fonts. I can change things very easily if I want to. I can very easily click into Edit and change any of these blocks if I want to. Put, you know, double click in here for an image. Again, I have my image here. I could get rid of it. I have a pre-populated coupon, all of that. You know, let's say that this wasn't here. Sometimes people aren't sure about some of the blocks they can add. If you come over here to Blocks and you click on there, you get a lot of different things. Again, if you have a company logo, you could add that in. Let's say you're in a different template and it didn't pre-populate the introduction, the salutation. That's introduction. So what I would do is go to Introduction, drag it over into, and you got to make sure you go to a place where it shows you that it's going in. Click on there, and there it is, Dear First Contact name again. You know, you want to edit, because it gives you this pre-populated stuff, so I would come in and edit out that sentence and do whatever else I wanted to. So again, there's different things in Blocks. Closing block, if it wasn't on here already, you know, I would come down and add a closing block. You know, if I want my readers to sign up for something, I can, you know, I can add that somewhere. And of course, you'd move this around and join our mailing list, that kind of thing. So those are some of the features of Constant Contact's email, if you want to use one of their pre-populated emails. And again, I'm going to exit out of that, and I won't save any of those changes. And so I go back into my create emails again, and you know, I could find out which ones I want, and some of them, the blocks aren't available for all of the templates, so if I went into one that didn't have a block feature that I wanted, I probably wouldn't use that. But anyways, you can set up themes and things over here as well. There's a whole lot of stuff you can do with Constant Contact. That is our Constant Contact tutorial in 5 minutes or less.